Good evening and welcome to our Bible study. Today I will go over my notes from several visits I've done to the Kingdom Hall of Jehovah's Witnesses. But to start with, I'm going to read about chick publications. Chick publications, this one's Mama's Girls. Son, please read this on page 21. Okay, here, I'll read it on this one. Satan is attacking you by blinding your mind with confusion because you are his target. He's determined to bring you down. All right. So, the darts of the enemy, have you heard that part in the Bible? The helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, on and on, the sword of truth. I believe all of this is to ward off. In Tai Chi, there's a principle of ward off. When the punch comes, you just move it to the side or you get out of the way. Ward off. A rain coat wards off the water or an umbrella. So the darts of the enemy, and so that's why they have this picture of you are the target. And all right, now please read. What people like about this is the comic books. All right? I read one of these long ago, and it said that the communist people in China, the spies came to the United States and saw how kids spent hour after hour reading comic books. And so they wrote their beliefs, the Red Book, in a comic book format. And people like reading with pictures. Whether you believe or don't believe, or you agree or don't agree, people like reading with pictures. So come. You are learning animation. Please come. I want you to read this.
You're being misled by TV.
Misled.
Being misled by TV, phony religions, holy books, evolution, environmentalism, anything but Jesus. Satan hates you. The last thing he wants is for you to find out who this Jesus really is. Jesus Christ is the creator of the universe, all things that were made by him, and Jesus will judge the lives of everyone who ever lived.
All right. Now, there are two issues there. One says that Jesus was created by God. Jesus is not God. That's what the Jehovah's Witnesses say. In this one, it says that Jesus is God and he created everything.
No, there is a star.
Yes, that you got to go read John something. And then there's another one that there's a lake of fire. Some people say there is no lake of fire. And so on. The point I want to make is that you're being misled by TV, phony religions, holy books, evolution, environmentalism, blah, blah, blah. You see, I want to teach you what I have learned. That's why I make these videos. Some people want to teach you something else. Some people say, no, let the kids play video games 24 hours a day or 10 hours a day, whichever it is. But that would be wrong. All right? Children need to learn something that they can use later. I told you about a girl that was listening. You asked me what I was listening to on the radio, Dr. Dobson. He has a radio show called Focus on the Family. Now he has another one, something else. But in it, he was interviewing a lady on the radio that she was raped or molested by her father, who was rich. Then she took a train somewhere. And from there, she went from man to man to man, meaning different boyfriends. Why? Because she didn't have the money to buy her own food or pay for a place.
Cook, right?
Yes, that is only partial.
Yeah,
maybe she knows how to cook. She didn't say. But you still got to pay the rent and all these other things. So, That's why I want you to learn carpentry. You'll be able to fix tiny things everywhere. Someone says, please hang a mirror. You know how to do it. What, the what I'm teaching you?
No, that's
not the best way to hang a mirror. No. You can see all the screws, right?
And you, it doesn't look pretty.
Well, that tells you where you're at 11 years old. You gotta improve.
But I'm fast. Remember, I was like,
yes, you knew how to use the tools. So you know how to use the tools. That's wonderful. All right. So in school, they taught me recently, at the public school, they said there are four influencers. The parents, the peers, the teachers, and television, or the media. So I don't want to lose you. Who? What father wants to lose their son? You know, like the prodigal son? What father wants to lose him?
You lost your daughter.
Yes, I lost my daughter. Basically, I heard this comment on the same radio station that I hear Dr. Dobson. It said, you are the parent, and you say, you have three kids. No cookies before dinner.
What?
So one cookie says, very well, mother.
Wait.
No cookies before dinner.
Whoa.
In this example, the mother says to three children, no cookies before dinner. The first child answers, very well, mother.
Okay, I thought you said the first cookie.
The second child answered, aww. The third child stomped his feet and grabbed the ball and broke a window and closed the door and went into his room and closed the door. Now, all three children, only the first one was obedient. The second one was like, giving you a dirty look, sticking the tongue out. You've seen those dirty looks, right? I receive them sometimes. And then the third one got up, ran to his room and slammed the door. As a parent, you're the one that's supposed to tell the children when they can eat a cookie. Like after dinner, we'll be fine. You have no control about the child that is the least well-behaved. Now, that's what that mom said on the radio. What I would do is I would just remove that door. If you live in a tiny house, like a tipi, or maybe a little trailer in the backyard, something like that, they all have to behave. If they don't, well then, you don't get a door anymore. You know, you're going to be slamming your door, you don't get a door anymore. But you need the backup from the other parent. Otherwise, you can't get that. All right, here, you took these notes when you went to the Kingdom Hall. Please get familiar and read them to me. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Well, let's do this in another video. It's important to meditate and ask questions. What did I learn? What did I learn at the Kingdom Hall or at the church? What did my parents teach me? Did they teach me anything about money? Like in Rich Dad, Poor Dad, sometimes parents don't teach the right things about money. Go ahead and read those books. Rich Dad, Poor Dad by Robert Kiyosaki. God bless you and those that surround you.